This is a web page, and believe it or not, it contains the entire collected works of William Faulkner. Except it doesn't. It's just lorem ipsum, filler text. The point here is that the content on the screen, all this text, extends from the left edge of the viewport to the right edge. Now, in our actual project, we could center the content. We can align the content so it's centered inside our section, but that's not solving anything. Our eyes have to travel really far across the screen because it spans the full width of the viewport. So, what can we do? We can go through and manually adjust the width. We can set a maximum width on all our elements. That's not a great practice, because what happens when we drop something else in, another paragraph, it suffers from the same thing. Enter the container, the section's companion. We can drag a container element right into our section, then move our content, all the elements we have inside our section, into the container itself. Of course, the container keeps everything neatly bound. It keeps all your content inside a legible, reasonable region, and it sets the maximum width for the content inside to 940 pixels. And by design, the container functions just fine as we go down through our different views: tablet, mobile landscape, mobile portrait, and of course, TI-83+. And we can use our container to add extra breathing room. For instance, if we look on mobile landscape, we can see our content is being pushed right up to the edge. And in some cases, we might want that. But we can adjust our padding on the left and right by holding Option or Alt and dragging, let's say, about 10 pixels. And that'll give us some nice breathing room as we scale down. Of course, that styling passes down to mobile portrait as well. Once we've styled our container just how we want to, we can name our class. We'll name ours Amazing Container, and we can apply that class to other containers we add to our project. Now, how does this affect more complex layouts? Here's a section with no container, and the content spans the full width, suffers from the Faulkner challenge we encountered earlier. We can go in and drag a container right into the section, and since we created that class before, Amazing Container, we can apply that here too. Let's drag our content in from the section into the container, and as we do that, we have some much needed horizontal constriction, which keeps our content neatly bound. And if we check it on different device widths, it looks great. Generally, a good element hierarchy, if you're looking to use containers this way, is to have a container inside each section, and all the content you want neatly bound goes inside the container. So, content dropped in a section can work just fine. Sometimes the content gets a little unwieldy, spanning well beyond a practical width. Containers can be dropped inside our sections to keep everything neatly bound and organized.